let's jump in and talk about Zoom meeting chat. This is going to be really important for when you're facilitating, producing, or to support your participants as well. Things can happen and you want to know this. All right, so first of all, in your settings with the new meeting chat, you can go into your account profile settings through the browser here and allow users to save chats in the meeting. That's up to you. But the new meeting chat experience, you need to turn on. And then it's really important that you allow participants to delete messages in meeting chat. So you as a facilitator, host or co-host or your producer can delete if there's a problem in chat. You want to be able to delete it. But it's important too, if someone has a typo, to be able to delete it and then be able to type in a new chat is going to be really important sometimes to avoid issues. And then you can decide whether or not you want to enable screenshot feature in meeting chat. That's up to you. And allow participants to react to meeting chat using emojis. That's another way people can communicate. That's a lot of fun. Meeting chat, these are some changes too you can make during the meeting too. You can make a quick change and I'll show you that. Direct messages, or for myself, I always auto-save, so I don't have to worry about remembering that. And that's for myself as the host. And so those are some of the aspects of meeting chat. You can also send files during meeting chat. You need to turn that on if you're allowing that as well. So that's what we're focusing on today, is meeting chat. So I have opened it up here. It's right now I see it under more. If I want to turn that back off, when I've turned it off, then I will see it here on the bottom in the navigation right beside participants. I'm going to open up the chat panel. And what is new then, because we've turned on those settings, testing chat features, now I can edit before I post. So I can click format, I can highlight here and make it bold. I can even, there's under three dots here, more. I can make bulleted numbered lists, increase the indent, make it a quote. I can clear. So I can edit before. I can even strike out something here as well. And I can make the whole thing not this. So strike out features isn't working because I made this a quote, and I can clear the style. I can go back here, just showing you the possibilities. So that's editing before you post. Then with this little dot here, I am going to post it. Now I am the host right now, and you will then, once you've activated those new chat features, you can delete is really important. You can also copy something if you have posted something and then new participants have arrived and you want to post again what you just posted. That's going to be very helpful as well. And the three dots are beside it and underneath it. I can quote somebody else's to reply, and I can even edit that stuff as well. So I'm going to control enter or just click send. So testing, maybe you're typing too fast, you posted it, and then you can't edit after that. So I want to delete. It's going to confirm with me, and yes, I want to delete. And being able to delete participants' chats as well is going to be very helpful. Now here in chat, in the three dots in the top right, I can save the chat, if you didn't have it automatic, and I can change in the middle of the meeting, I can change that participants can only chat with the host and co-hosts or no one. Now the difference here is just everyone, or I can giving the option to post to everyone, or someone else that's another participant directly. So I like, as a participant, I like to have this option. Maybe I want to say hi to someone on the side. Yes, as a facilitator, maybe you don't want those distractions, but we're adults. And if you were in a room with someone, you might wave across the room and then focus on the facilitator. So I like giving adults all the control possible. And if there is an issue, I can shut it down, even if just for a moment before I send people to break, because I am sorting out an issue in the background. So with the delete, coming back to that, if someone has posted something that's inappropriate, didn't like it, there's a link or whatever, you might have a very large group. This is a way as hosts and co-hosts, facilitators and producers, that you can quickly delete it. Again, giving your participants the option to delete is really important. If you've typed something and you misspelled something or wrote the wrong name, or you all of a sudden realized, oh, that's what they meant, I didn't get it the first time, my chat is now irrelevant and I want to delete it, to be able to do that is really important. So I just wanted to highlight, you need to activate it in your settings in order for this to be able to even be an option. So turn it on here in your settings, activate new meeting chat experience. And even if you don't want the other things, but you allow participants to delete messages in meeting chat, is going to be super supportive to everyone and avoid situations that could arise or just make things more seamless. Thanks for checking this out. My name is Patricia Regier. And until next time, let me know, was this helpful? Give me a like, share, subscribe if you haven't, and then you'll know when I posted videos like this. And let me know in the chat, what types of videos would you like me to create in the future? Thanks again for checking this out. My name is Patricia Regier.